Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Principal's Life and Workbook by Ray Dalio, a timeless piece not to be missed, to be read, and re-reread to really assimilate the wealth of wisdom that Ray has shared. He even provides summaries and descriptions specifically so that you can skip to the information most relevant to you. The first part of the book that gives the origin story of Dalio's approach and his company is fascinating and interesting. The bits of that are included in specific principles felt less necessary, and sometimes got in the way of making the point of the principle itself. You may wish to read the first part of the book, then read the TL, Doctor Principles, and if there are principles that you feel need clarification, or you just want to hear more, then read more detail in the book. The author goes, and some granular details of how running a business effectively should be done. He talks about things like the importance of being open-minded, and how to run a business like an engine. The nice thing about the format of the book is it has index pages that emphasize or highlight a point that Ray is trying to articulate. To sum it up, it is a book about managing your business to get the best results, not because it's great, but because every thinking person should know what kind of people run the world. Dalio captures some of the essence of the extremely competitive, capitalistic, and materialistic culture of the United States. Dalio's conception of the nature of evolution as one leading to improvements is not part of the biological theory, but reminiscent of social Darwinism. It's one of those books that you experience differently based on what you're dealing with at the time you read it. There is a lot of information on creating a healthy and transparent work culture, and making sure you have the right people on the bus sitting in the right bus seats. Ray Dalio found a way to simplify the complicated by providing insight and guidelines as to how one can become an influential leader, run an organization transparently, all the while being true to oneself. If you, or anyone you know, is focused on growth or personal development, this is a powerful addition to increase the momentum of growth. In a world where most self-proclaimed business books are little more than a litany of motivational platitudes, Ray Dalio's tome is refreshing in its dryness. Every task or goal should have a responsible party whose job is to make sure it gets done, but not necessarily to do it himself. Choose the right person for the given task. Not everybody is good at everything just because they really, really want to be. People are believable only if they've successfully accomplished the endeavor in question at least 3 times. Weight others' opinions based on their level of believability, which should be quantified objectively and assessed dispassionately using impartial data, obviously. In the current climate of forced egalitarianism and smug virtue signaling, Ray's pragmatism is a fresh breeze. Not all opinions are equally valid. Honesty is more important than playing nice. Believing in yourself is not a substitute for hard work, and hard work is not a substitute for natural ability. Who has then moved to codify their approach through clear processes and procedures to create an environment that instills and reinforces self-awareness throughout the company that they created? It defines how to create an environment that forces those that participate in it to be self-aware. In many ways, it is a book of common sense, but as the author states, common sense isn't actually all that common. As such, it forces those that read it to become, for a short period at least, self-aware. There are many principles in this book, but the central and core principle is that Mr. Dalio believes the best ideas should win. He makes the rationale that this is the healthiest and most sustainable thing any company can do. Much of the practical wisdom is contextual, and can work for some, or most companies, but not all. Anyway, this is a good book, and it reminds you many points which you just forget to think about it. A good book to take people back to virtues that are lost in today's society, where people have a hard time looking inwards at their own flaws. If only the brittle souls out there could embrace these principles, many of our problems today could be avoided. That book is supposed to be about his view of economics, and not the neoclassical view frequently taught in universities. One of the main things to pay attention to in this book is Ray's way of dealing with problems. You really can't understand it unless you have lived it, or read about it here. Life principles were fantastic, and work principles were written specifically for those in higher up positions. It is only worthwhile if the time is taken to truly incorporate it into your life. What happened there? Other than that, the content of this book is worth much more than the sticker price. This book is a fantastic source for personal principles to guide you through just about anything in life or work. It's something that one can go back to reread and relearn from again and again. The book is so packed with information that it can become overwhelming to read and retain. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.